बार जो मैंने कमिटमेंट कर दी तो मैं खुद की भी नहीं सुनती, क्योंकि मेरा वचन ही मेरा शासन है। Hey folks, here Rachna Ranade here, and I welcome you all to another interesting video which is about the fascinating crypto world. So what are we going to discuss in today's video? We are going to talk majorly about three points, but the major chunk is going to be on what is a blockchain. We are also going to talk about P2P, which is also called as a peer-to-peer, and we are also going to talk about the third concept, which is about altcoins. Well, can you tell me whether this note is fake or is it legitimate? You might be saying that maybe I can put it through a machine and then check. Possibility number one. Possibility number two, you can see a number right there on the currency note. This number is maintained by the government authorities in their own records. But then the question arises, if someone tries to change those records, then what? Actually, the government authorities have a lot of power in their hands. It's said that power tends to corrupt, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. Well, I'm not trying to blame the government or not even trying to point out fingers at someone, okay? This is just an example. But this is where actually the concept of Bitcoin came into picture, wherein the people who came ahead with this idea of Bitcoin, everyone, I've talked about Satoshi Nakamoto in my previous lecture, but that's where the concept that we should not have a centralized power, it should be all about decentralization, this concept itself was born. Bitcoin is the first real life implementation of the blockchain technology, wherein the records are not kept by a single centralized authority, but the records are absolutely decentralized. But I'm sure you might not have understood this like 100%. We are going to take a simple example, and I'm sure in the next 5 to 6 minutes, everyone will understand the exact concept of a blockchain. Now let's understand a kind of a tricky concept, which is blockchain, with the help of a very simple example, okay? So I want your 100% attention for next just 3-4 minutes so that you will understand this concept absolutely, right? Is there a pen there? So let's start. So let's take an example where there are 50 ladies in a kitty party and everyone contributes 2 bitcoins as their contribution. You might be like, what? 2 bitcoins for a kitty party? Let's assume, what's the problem? Okay, so now what will happen is that every lady will contribute 2 bitcoins and there will be a lucky draw, and the winner will get how much? Obviously 100 bitcoins. There will be one lady who keeps all the records and everyone trusts her. My God, that lady might be getting that feeling of being Sivagami or Salman Khan, but then all of a sudden all the ladies say that we don't want to trust only that one single lady. Instead of that, we'll change the method and we'll ask 20 ladies to keep the records. Now, these 20 ladies are going to maintain their own copy of records. Now, what will happen? All the 50 ladies are trusting these 20 ladies as far as the records are concerned. Now, if someone were to commit a fraud, all of them, or at least majority of them, will have to be influenced. This exactly is a concept of a decentralized or a distributed trust. And this distributed trust forms the heart or the soul of a blockchain. Now let's again continue our example, where let us say out of these 50 ladies are 4 ladies, Hema, Rekha, Jaya or Sushma. All these ladies have 3, 3, 3 and 5 bitcoins in their balance. Okay, so now let's take one of the transactions to understand how this blockchain concept goes ahead. So assume that Hema sends 2 bitcoins to Sushma. Okay, so what will happen? Let's visualize. When this first transaction is made, every lady will have to verify whether this transaction really went through or not, or did it fail. Correct. Well, this transaction, however, is not written in plain English. You can visualize this like a complex mathematical problem. Now, remember those 20 ladies? They will start solving this complex mathematical problem and will try to verify whether this transaction really went through or not. Now, once the majority of them solve it, the data gets verified and everyone updates their own records. Well, those who are from a commerce background can easily relate to this because this is as good as passing an ordinary resolution at a general meeting. So coming back to the updation of records, of course, this is going to be done automatically. And those who solve the problem correctly, they obviously need to be rewarded. And this reward will be given in the form of cryptocurrencies. It will be given randomly to one of the women. It's as good as a lottery which is given. Now what happens in real life? Let's understand. 20 women in our example are no one but actually computers, and they are called as nodes. Whereas 50 women who are participating in the kitty will be termed as peers. Now whenever the transaction took place, you remember the first transaction that took place? As we said, someone will have to verify whether the transaction went through or not by solving that complex mathematical problem. This process of solving that complex mathematical problem is called as the proof of work. So, as we also said that at least 11 out of 20, that is a majority, when they give a green signal, this transaction will be approved. And this approved transaction gets added to a block, which is then updated in everyone's records. Now, please note, in real life, there will be many transactions in one block. Now, the rest of the ladies will start transferring their Bitcoins. Transactions will be approved and they will keep on adding the blocks in this entire blockchain. These blocks are linked to each other. Every block will have a summary of the previous block. So, I hope you are understanding that because these blocks are linked to each other, removing one of the blocks from the blockchain is going to be really difficult. Now, this ledger will be maintained by all the nodes, and this will be called as the public distributed ledger. This forms the basis of blockchain. But wait, there is still one more question which has remained unanswered. Now, assume that there is this lady, Juhi, who is also amongst the 50 ladies, and she wants to transfer 2 bitcoins when she has only 1 bitcoin in her wallet. Will this transaction go through or not? Will Juhi's transaction go through or not? Answer is no. Why? Will Juhi have to influence only one lady now? Now, instead of one lady now, we know about crypto. What are we going to say? Will Juhi have to influence only one node? No. She'll have to influence the majority of the nodes. Correct? Well, this is the case of this kitty party that we were talking about, right? In real life, what will happen? For example, if I were to transfer few bitcoins from my wallet and assume that I have 0 bitcoins, will I be able to convince all the nodes? Now, first question is, where are these nodes? Kidhar hai, dhundo, dhundo daya, kahin na kahin zarur mil jayenge. Where are these nodes? These nodes are located in different parts of the world. Just try to Google out. You will see that this is how big the mining farms are. This is huge. They are located in Switzerland, China, Russia, so many countries across the world. Now, do you think I'm going to influence all these different places in the world? Is this next to impossible? Yes. I hope you're understanding why we say that this is immutable. Immutable can't be cracked, can't be hacked. Because right now, if I were to hack it, I don't have to hack one computer. I have to hack all these nodes across the world, which are having so much computational power. Right? So I hope you have understood that in our example, Juhi's example, as well as my example, this system cannot be hacked. Now, I hope you have understood the concept of a block, blockchain, and so many concepts. So now let's understand what are the 5 important elements of blockchain. Had I started my lecture with this part, you might have gone like mad. Now, what is this happening? Because now read out these words. What are the 5 elements of blockchain? It has to have a peer-to-peer network. There is something known as cryptography. There is a consensus algorithm. There is punishment and reward. And the last one is market adoption. Now, you might be like, what is this? Now, let us quickly relate this with our example. The very first one is peer-to-peer network. Who are our peers? 50 ladies. So, there was a peer-to-peer network. Second one is cryptography. Cryptography is what? That complex mathematical problem I told you. Transactions will not be in plain English. They'll be in complex mathematical problems, so that's cryptography. Third one, consensus algorithm. Consensus, majority of them have to say yes, more than 50%, right? That's the consensus algorithm. Next one is punishment and reward. You remember I told that because the ladies were solving the problem correctly, few ladies will get that reward, or at least one lady will get the reward, right? So that is nothing but the reward, say 0.005 bitcoins or whatever, right? And the last one is market adoption. If you remember, I told you that everyone has to have a faith in the system, that yes, we should go from a centralized trust to a decentralized trust. Now, let's understand what is the concept of P2P or a peer-to-peer. Now, we already know what is a peer. Our 50 ladies, they were peers, right? So, if you want to know the meaning of that, the technical meaning says that in financial terms, the term peer-to-peer is usually referred to the exchange of cryptocurrencies or digital assets via a distributed network. Did you understand the meaning? If no, again, have a look at this diagram. What was this? This was a diagram wherein we talked about all those 50 ladies. Who were those 50 ladies? They were the peers, right? So when one lady was transferring cryptos to the other lady, what was that? It was a peer-to-peer transaction. And this transaction took place through a centralized network or through a decentralized network. Of course, yes, it took place through a decentralized network. So even if there is no exchange in between, still such transactions can take place through a peer-to-peer network. With this example, I hope you have understood the concept of P2P very easily. And this was with the help of, course, WazirX. I would like to thank them because they are helping me to create more and more content on the entire crypto space. WazirX has recently come up with the quick buy feature as well, wherein investing in cryptos becomes very easy. You can also explore this feature and this entire app by checking out the link in the description box. Now, let's understand what are altcoins. Altcoins are nothing but alternate coins. Alternate to what? Bitcoin. I means any cryptocurrency or any coin which is not a Bitcoin is an altcoin. Whoa, is that simple? Yes, it is. So, what are the examples of altcoins? I can say that there are various examples like Litecoin, Ethereum, Ripple, WazirX coin. So, there are many coins. Okay, all these are what? All these are altcoins, right? But then why do these altcoins exist? Is there any use case for these altcoins? Answer is yes. So I'll give you a simple example. For a Bitcoin transaction to take place successfully, it takes almost 10 minutes to verify the transaction. Okay. To counter this drawback, one altcoin came into picture, which was the Litecoin. Litecoin has the capacity to complete the transaction in just 2.5 minutes. Okay, so what is the use case of that coin? Tell me. Use case is that the transaction will become much faster as compared to the Bitcoin. Okay, now let's understand that are there only 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever altcoins I said, only these many? Alright, there'll be hundreds of altcoins. Now the big question is that out of hundreds of altcoins, how shall I decide which altcoin is good for me to make an investment into it? Okay, so like we do fundamental analysis of shares, we can also do a fundamental analysis of all these crypto coins, right? Well, by the way, all the people in this space call it as digital assets. That is actually an appropriate word. But then we'll talk about this word and go into more details in some other lecture regarding cryptocurrencies. Right now, we'll term it as cryptocurrency or crypto coin only, right? So, very first one, how do I decide which altcoin is to be bought? The very first one, try and understand the use case of that altcoin, okay? So, for try and understand what makes it unique. Okay, just because it's a meme coin, that is not why it is unique. You have to understand the use case as well. Okay, if you feel that the use case is really good, you can consider that as one of the positive factors. Second one, please don't fall prey to the pump and dump scheme. Now, what is this? Pump means some hype will be created about that stock. You know recently what had happened, right? Hype will be created. Array, this will go to $1, tweets and all that, right? It will go up in the air and then that is where you will buy. And then it will start falling and falling and falling. And what will you say? Asakasakai, right? That is going to happen if you fall prey to the pump and dump scheme. Number three, try and check whether that cryptocurrency has a good market capitalization or not. Now, you will say market capitalization, that is like in share market. Well, that same concept comes up in crypto market as well. How do you calculate the market capitalization of a cryptocurrency, it's calculated as number of coins in circulation multiplied by the dollar exchange rate. Now the big question is that where will I get this market capitalization? Where will I get all this information about these altcoins and all that? That is what we are going to check in the next section of this video. So now let's understand what is coin market cap. If I were to give a comparative website for stock market, it's like Money Control. Okay, wherein you can understand a lot of information. On Money Control, you'll get information about shares. In coin market cap, you're going to get information about cryptos, right? So here, if you see, I'm just scrolling down a little bit. This is where you'll start getting information about so many currencies. Okay, I'm just going down. And this is like up to 100. And this is just page one out of whatever. Okay, so now I hope you're understanding. So many cryptocurrencies are in play right now. Okay, what all information can I see? I can see the latest price. Okay, I can see that in last 24 hours, Bitcoin has gone down by 6.2%. I can see that in the last 7 days, it has gone up by 3.46%. I can see that the current market capitalization is, please don't ask me to read that out. It's a very big number. Billions of dollars of market capitalization. Okay, then you can see how much is the volume. Volume means what? How many Bitcoins were exchanged? Okay, how many Bitcoins were exchanged, right? Then comes the circulating supply. Now, what is the circulating supply? It's as good as how many Bitcoins are right now available in the market for being exchanged. It's as good as an issued capital in stock market terms. Okay. Then you can also see a graphical trend of last 7 days, how it has performed and all that. Now, if I want to check out a very specific crypto. So, for example, I want to know more about Ethereum. What do? I just click here. Okay. Once I click, this new page will be opened for Ethereum. Now it says rank 2. Does it mean this is the like second best coin? No, this is rank 2 by market capitalization. Okay. Now what else can you see? You can see here www.ethereum.org. So like this is as good as saying that it is that company's website. When I talk about stock market, I would go on TCS website. Here it's like going onto that cryptocurrency's website. I hope this is clear. Okay. Explorers is a normal one. Community is a very important point. This is where you can get to, you know, talk to people who are like-minded, who are actually tracking that specific coin only. So, for example, if I just click on reddit.com, this is more of like a thread where you can see the thought process of so many people. You can see what many people have to talk about crypto, about this specific crypto, Ethereum. Will it happen 2.0 and all that? Whatever, so many points are given in this specific thread, right? The next one is source code. You can get an access directly to the source code of Ethereum. This is useless for a person like me because I don't understand anything about codes and all that. Okay, but for software engineers, it'll be very important. And the next one is a white paper. Now, what is this white paper? In again, stock market terms, it is like a prospectus. Okay, so whenever a company has to come up with an IPO, they have to file a prospectus. Similarly, when I'm talking about launching a crypto, in that case, white paper has to exist. It will consist of all the history, geography about that coin. In Hindi, I can say contains on all the kundali of the entire cryptocurrency. Okay. So, well, there are so many points which can be discussed here. It's just that the more and more you dig into details, more and more you will get to know about this space. Well, I hope you have enjoyed this today's video about three major concepts. Number one, we talked about what is the concept of blockchain. Number two, we talked about a P2P network. And number three, we talked about altcoins. Do let me know in the comment section whether you are liking this crypto knowledge. It's a completely different world that we talk about, right? And also let me know in the comment section which specific other terminology would you want to know about cryptocurrencies from me. Till then, take care. Jai Hind and bye-bye.